Hi, my name is LaFaya with the LaFaya Way. I'm a licensed marriage and family therapist with over 20 years of experience working with difficult relationship issues, especially when it's pertaining to hypersensitive children. Today, I'm going to discuss three ways to reduce anxiety when transitioning from summer to school season. Just in short, the four concepts within the LaFaya Way are: find your calm is number one, get to the honest truth is number two, three is understand your truest desires, and four is reflect and reinforce those behaviors that you're looking to get. Again, if you'd like more detailed discussion on that, you'll find my discussion on the LaFaya Way and you'll get more of that. Just understand that within everything it is that I teach, you'll find those four concepts kind of weaved in. The number one way that I have for today to reduce your anxiety when school starting is know what to expect and verbally prepare your child proactively for what may come up, okay? So some of the things that come up for especially hypersensitive children who are starting school is an increase in anxiety, difficulty sleeping. They may have some changes in behavior. Maybe a little bit more anger, a little bit more, you know, easily upset and all of that. So keep in mind that it may have to do with that increase in anxiety that school is going to start. The sooner that you prepare your child for this potentially happening, you kind of problem solve early before there are problems. Instead of they're acting out and you're kind of acting out with them because you don't understand what's going on, you're kind of preparing them ahead of time saying, hey, you know, school's starting up in about a couple weeks. Trust me, you're not planting ideas in their head. I think some parents say, well, what if I say that to them and that causes them to do these things or causes them to feel like this is gonna happen? No, it doesn't cause anything. It just prepares them ahead of time for something that may come up for them before school starts. The better prepared that they are, the more easy it is for them to do what they need to do to feel a little bit better about that, or at least when the feelings start to come up, they know where it's coming from. Oh yeah, I'm gonna start school soon. That's probably where all this stuff is coming from. And it also prepares you. Number two is proactive communication with the school staff. So if you can see if there are multiple teachers, to meet with each one individually or send an email out or something where you're kind of preparing them ahead of time. You know, some parents are like, well, I don't want to, you know, give the teachers a bad idea about my kid. It's not really about giving them a bad idea. It's kind of helping them to be prepared ahead of time for certain behaviors so that you don't have your child maybe getting into trouble for things that aren't really problematic behaviors people already know about them. You may have a child who maybe needs to get up out of their seat and, you know, take a walk outside for a minute because they get a little bit more anxious when they're, you know, they're in a big group of kids. Just keep in mind that sometimes the teachers are really busy. They don't have time to read the IEP and 504s. I know some parents, that's upsetting to them, but that's the way it works in the real world. So as opposed to being upset about that and complaining about that, just already know that that's a possibility and kind of try to put a little cushion there so that you're not, you know, as upset because you're being proactive. If you're not able to meet with the teachers, each teacher individually, just as many as you can possibly get to. And sometimes it's just about coming in on that first day of school if you can't reach them before class starts, because I'm sure most of the teachers are there 5 minutes early or so, and saying, hey, can I bend your ear for just a second? You know, because I had a hard time reaching you, you know, over the summer, whatever. One good example I have is back when my daughter was younger, she had a tendency to shut down if she was called on in class. If the teacher would call her name to answer a question, whether she knew the answer to the question or not, if they surprised her with it, she would shut down. And some of the teachers, they would view this as a behavioral issue as opposed to really being able to understand that she just has a hard time. Like, she truly goes into this panic mode when she's called upon without any warning. And so what I started to do was, after I had a problem with one of her teachers, each year I would go in and I would explain to them, hey, if you want to ask her a question, especially during class, give her a little warning, like two questions before, say, hey, Maya, we're going to come to you in a second with a question, so she's already prepared herself. And it really did fix the problem. It was no longer viewed as a behavioral issue, as if she was being defiant. It was just more they understood that's how it works for her. And one really great part is me being proactive in that and actually doing that for my daughter each time. She actually addressed me when she was going into the fifth grade. She said, Mom, why do you keep telling my teachers that? And I told her, I said, because you shut down when they call on you. And she told me, I don't want you to tell them that. And I said, well, if you don't want me to tell them that, then you have to work on not shutting down. Are you going to be able to do that when they call on you? She said, yes. I said, well, then I'll trust you to do it, and I don't have to tell them from now on. And from then on, she was able to kind of pull out of that whole shutdown thing. So, you know, when they're ready, they'll tell you. And number three is adjust your sleep schedules starting 1 to 2 weeks before school starts. And not just their schedule, but your schedule. Because as a parent, you do still have, you have to transport them everywhere. If they're younger, there are a lot of things that we as parents have to do that we require more rest for as well. And we're setting the example for our kids saying, hey, we're not just telling you that, you know, you have to make sure you're getting enough rest before you start school, but we're gonna do the same thing, model the behavior that it is you're looking for, and you're more likely for them to kind of buy into it. So it's always good to set that better example for your kid as well. So those are my three. If you have questions about what it is I've shared today, because you know I can't give you everything, but if you have specific questions, then please email me at info@pomtsolutions.com. Until next time, stay you and stay true.